Roast Talks.
Roast Talks.
Episode 2.
Sauciest podcast in the world. Grimiest podcast in the underground.
Grimiest.
Grimiest of all time.
Grimiest.
Number 2, Big 2. Double O. It's real good, y'all. So, how's it been? Since we filmed the last pod, what's y'all reflections?
Man, I don't know. I just enjoyed the editing process and just talking to the homies on the regular. Like,
yeah.
It was fucking fun. Just getting back into the rhythm of things, you know. I think, like, we're just gonna get better as time goes on. Like, the more we record, the better at potting we're gonna get.
100%. I agree with that.
That's how it was last season.
That's kind of what I want to show the audience. Like, grow with us, you know. We're gonna sound a way at the beginning, but like, wait till we get to like pro status.
I don't want y'all to grow with us, bro, because we're gonna say a lot of dumb shit that we probably gonna contradict in like the next few episodes or something.
Yeah, we're all still young, like, as fuck.
We still grown, we still learn, we're still thinking. So I might say a bad take, but like, you know.
Definitely. I think they just got to be ready for bad takes, like on the regular. Because I think.
On the regular? You think it's because.
On the regular, yeah.
Yeah, because of me. Because of you too, definitely, you know. I think we're just young, you know. We still got a lot to learn about life.
My takes are pretty good, though. But I got a revelation, bro.
What?
My final revelation.
What's your revelation?
I'm done with weed. It's over. Forever. I'm done, bro. It's gone. Out of my life.
Why is that?
Cause, bro, I just been seeing what that shit's been doing to me. And I'm not liking it, bro. Just like when I started smoking weed and like the life events that happened and shit, like it's not good, bro. It wasn't an uphill. It was more of a downhill.
Was there a certain thing that made you change your mind on weed?
Certain feeling.
Like, was there a certain time you smoked? And after you smoke, you realize, like, maybe this is just too much.
When I started, like, forgetting shit, like, when I forget shit, when I, like, my brain is mad foggy all times, like, I'll get headaches and shit. Just, like, wake up on a normal day with a fat-ass headache.
Well, how often did you smoke?
Every day, like.
How often? Like, how many times a day?
Like, 2, 3, like.
You don't think it was them cigarettes? Bumbaka!
No, because I wouldn't smoke those. I did as only smoke those at times like this, like when I have to perform or some shit.
I got something I gotta admit to.
You gay?
Nah, fuck you, bitch. Ever since last pod, you know, I was talking shit about cigarettes, but I smoked like 7 cigarettes in the time from the last episode. So, like, yeah. That's 7 days ago, crazy. I smoked 7 cigarettes in this whole week.
7 cigarettes is crazy.
7 cigarettes is crazy. Good that you counted, though. Keep count.
Yeah, I don't plan on smoking a lot more cigarettes, but, like, you know, just when in Rome, you feel me, you just gotta hit them. How long has it been since you stopped smoking weed?
It's been like 3 days.
Do you feel any better?
Yeah, I feel like more, you know, like, you know, here, more in the present, more really, like in real life.
What are you doing when you have those instances of like you want to smoke so bad but you don't want to smoke?
I don't know.
Like, are you just shutting it down like completely when it comes in your brain? Like, damn, I could really smoke right now.
Yeah, it's just like being okay with going through pain and shit like that, and like doing shit you don't want to do. It's like being okay with that, really. Because I don't do anything specific. I just really just
fucking meditate and shit.
Yeah, like withstand it. Just sit there and like, oh. Yeah.
I just feel like me personally, my stance of weed also, like, I feel like changed a little bit as well. After smoking for a good amount of time now, like, you kind of start seeing the side effects.
Yeah.
Especially in my lungs. Like, I sometimes feel like congested sometimes from smoking way too much. Or like when I'm when I'm exercising and shit, like, the deep breaths you take aren't as deep as how you were, you know, a couple years back when you were just clean.
You think you can balance it out with the right diet and exercise?
Yeah, I feel like you can definitely clean it. Your body's like a car. You can definitely clean it out. It just takes time. Like, you just gotta.
It might have to do with the weather, you know, and like, you know, the season that the smoking just doesn't.
I don't think so.
I think people come to a realization, because I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah.
The fact that people say that weed actually makes you lazy is actually facts.
I think it's facts too.
I feel like me personally, there's some days where I will roll 3 to 4 times, bro, and it's just consecutively, and I would get nothing done. You know what I mean? Like, it definitely takes a toll on people, on certain things. Like, you really like freeze up on the weed. Like, the weed literally has you stuck on that shit.
That's what I want to say. I think like long term effects with weed is really not a good thing, bro. Yeah, and that's what I'm like feeling, because it's been like I haven't really like stopped smoking for a long period of time, for like a couple years, sophomore basically.
Sophomore year in high school.
Yeah, literally.
I feel like I'm living proof of like, you know, what the damages of weed do. Like,
yeah.
Right before we were recording, like I had a good day today. I was smoking, you know, carts and shit. And I smoked the blunt. With,
that's his problem, bro. He smokes straight carts.
I smoked the blunt with Julio. Now.
I tried telling him, stop with the cart shit, because low key, you're just inhaling toxins. Like, you're inhaling shit that's not
straight
good for your
oil.
Body.
Yeah, it's not
really. I'm not saying that even smoking weed is good, because at the end of the day, the weed we smoke now is not like the weed people were smoking back in the day. Like, some of the, I feel like sometimes,
because that shit was boof. That's
shit, got GMOs in it now.
Yeah,
bro.
Like, this shit became genetically, like, it's like GM, like,
in a lab, niggas is creating the best strains.
And that happened ever since they legalized weed.
Exactly. Once they legalized weed, they started spraying that shit with any kind of chemical, bro.
It was like,
nah, that's scary, bro. That's sick.
I mean, yeah. I mean, that's what they do. Once the government comes in, you know, it's always no good.
Exactly.
China's all fuck out.
Once they know they can make profit off it, they know like they could also.
Yeah, that's kind of funny, because they actually do sell fake weed.
On your life,
like Chinese, like China sell fake weed, bro. I know that.
I think they invented K2, bro.
They did.
Probably did, bro.
I'm pretty sure they did. No, I'm pretty not K2.
Anything, like, if you hear synthetic, I'm going to immediately assume it came from China, bro. Like,
they're the number one, like, fent dealers, though.
Oh, yeah, 100%.
Heron dealers. Everything, bro. They literally created, like, opiates.
Nah, but the British fucked them, though. That was, like, back in the day. But that was all the British, like, doing grimy shit to them. And had them, like, hooked on fucking heroin and shit.
Bro, the British created a lot of fucked up situations.
But then they kept it going, you feel me? And
they was also fucking in India. Fucking with India.
Yeah.
Like, they created a beef between India and Pakistani.
Yeah.
Nah, they ain't a forever
Yeah,
beef.
I forgot. I be feeling like that beef be deep as hell sometimes, too. Especially in, like, they play, like, cricket.
Yeah,
that should be, like, mad tight for them. Like, cricket is, like, soccer for, like, Hispanics. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, that shit get deep.
It's deep.
Yeah. Wrestling, too. That shit look kind of cool. They be, like, slapping each other on the chest and shit.
You see that shit?
Like the Superman slaps. That shit, I love that shit.
Bro, there's the guy with the red and black stripes, where he's like the Hulk Hogan, John Cena, that shit, bro.
And they got like the elbow fucking tassels and shit.
He's undefeated, though. You see him get work done, bro.
Wait, are we talking about that, like, UFC episode, like that other program they have, like that other, like the slap box shit?
Nah. We're talking about Indian slap boxing tournament.
So India has their own slap boxing tournament.
Yeah, it's like 3v3s. It's like tag team matches, and they do like no face shots, just slapping each other's titties, bro.
What the fuck?
I know, bro.
Just Superman slaps to the chest. I'm like, I don't know what is the. Does somebody got to tap out eventually? Like,
oh, so they was doing like the Great Khali to each other. You know how Great Khali?
slap
on the chest.
I don't know. That shit seems entertaining, bro.
It does seem entertaining. I'm not hating.
That's like definitely pro wrestling for them guys.
Like, Senegal got like the fucking the circus Ferris wheel with the motorcycles and shit.
Oh, yeah.
Like, driving a circle. It's just cool.
You know, in Chile, they do a tradition. It's like a festival, a holiday where everyone runs fades, bro. The whole entire town runs rumbles, bro. Like, the whole day.
That's crazy.
Anybody that got beef, anybody that just wants to fight, like, they got a spot on them for the card and shit.
Like, the Purge, but only fist fighting.
When is it?
I think it's like in May or some shit.
You should go.
We should go. I'm down to go cop tickets at Chile and run my 30s. Whoever won.
Imagine growing up in that. I'd be scared of shit. The fuck?
What?
Yeah, they be having kids fight too.
Yeah, like.
They be having women fight. La senoritas.
Especially me as a kid, I'm pussy. So, like, I would have been. Would have been me.
They be having senoras fight, bro. Senores, bro. They be having a little chamaquitos fight, bro. It's everybody fight.
Oh, that's sad. I don't want to see that.
It's crazy.
Little Spanish women are like my kryptonite. That shit made me cry. Like, I was watching the
black grandmas are my kryptonite.
Yeah.
But white MILFs though, like GILFs.
GILFs?
Yeah.
What you think? What's your take on GILFs?
I like to fuck them.
This man a freak.
Never mind.
I like old ladies. I feel like old ladies are just nice people. But some of them are fucking, like, working in retail, you know, as the old ladies are fucking, like, conniving snakes, bro. They're mad fucking weird.
Nah, they just be bored, bro.
Yeah, exactly, which makes them really fucking, like, horrible people. They just come
into retail because they just have no association, like, with people in their house and shit.
So they decide
if you're dealing with an old white lady, if she's tripping about something, and you immediately solve that problem for her, she's going to look at you dumb as fuck, like, oh, like.
Nah, she's going to treat you like God, bro.
You have the possibilities to solve that. Like, I'm sorry.
Like, when you solve old people's problems, they treat you like God. They're like, oh my God, you know how to do everything.
Have you ever had like a weird vibe from an older white person? Like, doing something.
They
want to
fuck you?
No, not like
that.
I have that. I get that vibe a lot.
Yeah, I get that vibe.
But like a racist vibe.
Oh, yeah.
All the time, bro. All the time.
Yeah, definitely.
Some people really don't love speaking their mind, bro. They hold like nothing back. Mm-hmm. Like, they'll say some racist shit right in front of you.
Yeah.
And then you just like, what the fuck? Like, it's so open. Like, they just tell you that shit.
I feel like, because since I'm black, they're always trying to, like, they're, like, trying to jump around it. Say some race. They try to say some racist shit, but they're trying to, like, jump around it so they're not actually saying it.
They'd be like, but wow, like, you got a lot of swagger
shit. You know what I mean?
And I'm like, bro, watch out, bro. I just got to give you a fucking carpet. Like, move.
They're like, thanks, kid.
Yeah.
Don't even call you kid.
Go ahead and put that into a trunk for me, boy. What are you doing? Like, I've been called boy by like a lot of people in the restaurant I work at.
For real?
Yeah, as a busser and as a server.
Like
boy. Talking,
like boy.
Like pass.
Boy, come here.
Like, boy, come here. Pass me the water, boy. I'm like, boy.
Boy. But you pass him the water, though.
Yeah, what am I supposed to do? Sock cuz out, like, right then in the spot?
I feel like you should be allowed to. I hate that I can't. Like, if somebody called me the N-word, I should be allowed to beat the dog shit out of you. Because that's crazy. Like, come on. You don't think I'm human? So I'm going to beat the shit out of you.
What if they're, like, just mentally challenged? They don't know no better.
Oh, well, nigga, I'll know that afterwards. I'm going to be like, oh, okay. Okay, never mind. I don't condone that whatsoever.
Yeah, I'm telling you. That's what I'm trying to tell you when we, like, you're going to hear some bad takes.
Blueface. That nigga in jail, though.
Blueface is in jail?
Yeah, he's in jail. She just had a baby or whatever.
Yeah.
Soulja Boy just talking shit.
There's a lot of people talking shit. I think Charleston White was talking about some, he got money on the baby being.
He was betting on the kid.
Like, it was crazy.
That's crazy. That shit makes me so sad that they're fucking with a child's life like that. That shit is fucked up.
Yeah, I've never seen like a child get dragged on the internet more than this fucking kid.
What? You know how many kids get?
Kids,
the last kid that I seen that was getting dragged on was crazy was Lana Rose's kid.
Yeah.
It was kind of crazy.
Blake Griffin Jr.? That's what you mean?
And then Lena the Plug's kid.
Lena the Plug kid, like that. Yo, it's like, it's really some crazy ass, like, bro, we're coming to a time period, like, kids these days have no, like,
safety net.
Yeah, bro, it's raps.
Yeah,
the internet is so big nowadays. Back in the old days, like, people like bomb on you and shit like that, right? Like, yeah. now it's bro,
I feel like we came up during the age where like cyberbullying became a thing.
That's something I don't understand. If you already posted shit about other people on Instagram or on Facebook or anything,
bro, like schools, especially nowadays, are cutthroat. You know, they're making the fucking, like, back in the day you had the burn books and shit where you just talk shit and spread rumors. Now you got the fence. You got this. The page, bro. Like,
you got the pages, bro.
You got like the Trenton Thought page, bro. Or the Hamilton West Hoes or some shit.
Yo, that's wild to me.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, bro. I remember that shit. That shit.
But I'm saying though, bro, like, kids nowadays have nothing, like, bro.
No safety.
Half of these kids, like, we're living in a time period where OnlyFans is like becoming the number one thing. Like, selling yourself online pages to make bread. Yo, imagine how many kids. Imagine you going to school and they find out that your mom's an OnlyFans model, bro. And then her shit get leaked.
That's crazy.
I'm just saying, though.
What can
though,
you do, bro? You just got to
move that's a different
school
type of bullying, bro.
Yeah, that is a different type of bullying, but it's really like.
Yo, like, what are you doing? Imagine you
said that bullying 6 years ago.
But I'm saying, though, imagine you sitting in that classroom when they put that shit on a projector and it's your mom getting ripped, bro.
That's crazy. First
of all. Yo, just think about that shit, yo. Because, bro, some kids really would be that grimy to put that shit up. Yeah.
That's the reality, bro.
But. Come on, bro. Niggas just
because they do not care about school anymore. When I realized that we graduated high school during COVID and everything was done online, I realized like the school system was going to like be fucked up.
It was fucked. I mean, it's getting fucked.
Yeah, because everybody graduated that class online though. Think about it.
Yeah, honestly, if it wasn't like in 2020, if it wasn't for like remote, you know, school from the computer, I wouldn't have graduated.
Yeah, I had a lot of absences.
I had too many absences, and I was like, I was checked the fuck out, to be honest.
Yeah.
But I'm saying, though, like, that shit is, like, ever since 2020, that's, like, schools, everything's been, like, pretty shit. The whole world's been ass.
Really? But they put an AC in my school when I fucking left, bro. Like, I drive past that AC unit every day, that big-ass AC unit outside of school. I'm like, nigga, I was in a heat box.
Yo, we got a whole new school, bro. I was only in there for 6 months.
Yeah, no cap.
I was only here for 6 months. I went there like
that sucks.
I went there like 2 years ago, and like the bathroom was all crackled up and shit. Like everything looked fucked up.
Oh man, them train kids like did not take care of it.
I don't know why, bro. I don't know why we have the tendency of not taking care of the shit.
I mean, that's just the state of our fucking like.
Bro, we had like one. We had like three janitors, bro, for like an entire building. We had like three janitors.
Yeah, but that's just the state of like our area, our economics, bro. You know, like kids don't know no better because there's no better in their lives, bro. Everything they know is all like to shit and kind of like scuffed. So how the fuck do you expect them to like treat their environment?
Yo, like, do you, you remember when we used to go on school field trips and shit like that? I don't even think they even do that anymore. Like, kids ever get taken?
Yeah, world isn't even safe like that.
Nah, they probably still do it the same way with all the fucking, like.
You think that's what it is, though?
All the smart kids
will get. You think it's because the world is not safe no more?
I mean, the world was never safe, bro. I don't think.
But it's not as safe as, like, the way it is now. Like, I feel like anything can happen nowadays.
Even before, if the world wasn't safe, there's still, like, that safety net, you know, that, like, sense of, like, hey, everything's all right, you know? Like, the little blindness to it.
Bro, like, I'm saying,
but, like, if you're thinking how blind. Like, why? But why do you think those kids don't have the same blindness that we had when we were in their age? Like, they could just have that same blindness. Because
they have access to the truth, bro.
There was crazy shit going on that we have also access to, but that we were just not tapping into. You know what I mean? Like, we
that's
were
just the shift. That's how we were very new with technology.
Because I was a little ass kid. I didn't give a fuck about nothing. I just didn't care, bro. I would see shit that I knew. I just didn't peep it.
I'm just saying, though. Like,
I didn't absorb it, like, really.
Let's talk about Vince McMahon. Let's talk about the owner of the WWE resigning from all his positions because of his leak. The leakage of the fact that he had been sex trafficking his employees, bro.
Is it a leakage or is this like an actual lawsuit that he's facing?
No, it's a lawsuit that he's facing.
Just facing, yeah.
But the text messages have been revealed.
That's kind of crazy.
He paid off like multiple John.
That's the thing I've been known about this. You know, he had already signed had made people sign NDAs so that he can keep his position in the company. This has been going on for years.
I'm like, I'm not surprised at all.
The beginning of him running the Wrestling Federation.
Like, nigga was doing storylines where like, bitches were like, if you fuck this guy, then he would, like, you're going to be up in the whatever the fuck.
Yeah, he really wasn't.
Like, he wasn't hiding that secret. Shit. Like, he really was not hiding.
Like, he didn't he didn't run programs about sex trafficking.
Yeah, not explicit, but like.
Maybe there was a program where I think Triple H kidnapped Stephanie McMahon. And then did something to her.
I'm saying, I know. I've seen a lot of subplots like that. Or like where they would do weird shit. But
I don't know. I mean, maybe WWE was one of like the first things that showed us like that kind of shit.
The real world?
No, it's
no,
just
not
like
the real world,
ignorant.
But just like that adult shit. Like, remember when like there was mass scenes of like wrestlers having quote unquote sex on the ring and shit like that?
You talking about Edge?
Yeah, there's one with Edge, right? Yeah. There's one, like, I'm saying this is in front of little ass kids too in the stadium.
Yeah.
That's true.
And I'm saying, this is way back in the day. No one's really, like, no one really thinks about that
different
shit.
Different times, bro.
If you want to, like, look at America's mentality, just look at WWE. That's basically, that's the example of America right there. That's, like, everything like, about WWE.
The generations, too.
Yeah, everything about WWE is American as fuck. Like, all those ideas, like. And they were peddling it to kids. Like, you got to think about it. All that insane shit that they were peddling to kids. Like, we were the main audience, bro. Little kids. And all that creepy shit was going on, bro. Like, that's crazy. But I loved it, though, when I was a little kid.
Bro, I'm still a fucking wrestling fan to this day, bro. Like, once you get into those rabbit holes, like, listening to shoot interviews and, like, just understanding, like, the vocabulary they would use and shit, you get, like, entwined with the culture, like, the wrestling culture shit.
Yeah, because wrestling is cool. Like,
It's really not, though. Like, wrestling is cool as fuck. I think it's a sick
art
form.
I'm saying, yeah. That's what I'm saying. I was about to say. The art form is really cool. Like, right. All the way they do and they make up the storylines.
Storytelling, gymnastics, you know, just sports and everything.
The toll it takes on your body.
Combined in one. Like, yeah. Reality TV, you know, storyline. But the internet wrestling community, bro, among some of the most lame, retarded motherfuckers on the internet,
bro. Because it's the content is very much dumb, American. Like, yeah, American, hard headed, and ignorant. So, like, that's the audience you're gonna get.
It's very hillbilly backwoods.
But like, if you look at the artistic side of it, it's pretty.
That's why, like, there's different wrestling in the world. You know, there's wrestling in Mexico, there's wrestling in Japan, bro. Strong Style in Japan, Lucha Libre in Mexico. Like, there's different wrestling.
Japan's really cool.
Yeah, bro, it's fucking sick. Like, I wrestling is my culture, bro. You know what I'm saying? But, like, it's so fucked up now, like, that the first time, like, wrestling's being brought up in the mainstream news is over a fucking scandal of the owner, of the person who basically, like, monopolized wrestling and then, you know?
The wrestling family, basically. The fucking.
He's a fucking disgrace to humanity, bro. He's a billionaire and a disgrace to humanity, bro.
He was always, like, obviously a dirtbag, but now, like, it's
obviously, he was a dirtbag.
It's on paper, like, that he really
was. He was like Mr. Krabs.
Yeah,
Mr. Krabs our era.
Yeah, the evil Mr. Krabs. He definitely was Mr. Krabs.
I think, yeah, Mr. Krabs would have definitely pimped out Pearl, bro. If he really had to.
Nah.
I think he had to. Down on some downtime.
Yeah, bro. Mr. Krabs
always
know
how to make money, nigga.
Bro. That's a Grammy-ass person.
You think he was the first one to teach us that we're supposed to chase that bread?
Mr. Krabs?
Yeah.
No, he's the first one who taught us, like, what to do with the bread. And
you're right.
Not give it the fuck up. Like, be
stingy. Not give it away?
Yeah. Stingiest motherfucker ever. Speaking about other fucking billionaires that are like you know, sex trafficking, bro. Vince McMahon is just another fallen giant, you know? This has been happening forever.
Yeah, it was him and who? Him. It was like Epstein, him.
Bro.
No, I mean, like, in the court case, though. Like, it was more than just Vince McMahon.
Him, John Laurinaitis, and Brock Lesnar.
Yeah,
and
Brock
then, like,
Lesnar.
Pretty much most of the guys that were under Vince McMahon's wing, you know, like.
Yeah, like his surrounding clique.
His surrounding, yeah, people.
They were all, like, offering sexual favors and shit. Or he was, like,
actually, I remember there was a.
Peddling girls.
There was a scandal about Pat Patterson back in the day. Who used, he was a gay guy. And he used to touch little boys. Like, who would want to train to be wrestlers and shit.
Oh, shit.
That's supposedly, though. You know? I really don't know. But judging by how the fact that the Vince McMahon shit is going, like, I believe it, you know? I wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah. And how hard it is to become, like, a popular wrestler.
It really is, yeah. Especially during those times, you know, like the territory days and shit.
Yeah.
Bro, have you ever seen Dark Side of the Ring?
No, what's that?
No.
Documentary?
Yeah, it's a Vice documentary series where they talk about, like, just the darkest shit in wrestling, period. It's really good. If you haven't checked it out, go check it out. Shit's fire, bro. It's really, really interesting shit.
Is that good?
Yeah. Fire shit. Well, I mean, it's kind of depressing shit, but, like, it's fire.
Like, what was it about? It's just, like, the dark shit that... That happens in WWE and shit, or just
in just wrestling? In wrestling, like, so basically just stories, you know, but like things that actually happen, you know. So there's a movie that came out, I forget what his name was, Devon Erics, the story about Devon Erics, the brothers.
Yeah, right? The recent movie. Yes.
Yeah, the recent one was Zac Efron and shit. So there's five brothers.
That shit's sad.
They're all wrestlers. Their dad's a big wrestling guy who has his own company and shit, and then he's like building superstars to send to the WWE and shit, right? But they all end up like getting hooked on, like, you know, painkillers because wrestling is, like, taking a toll on their body. And they either die in accidents or kill themselves. Like, most of the brothers kill themselves.
Yeah, or, like,
I mean, I think that's a big problem in wrestling, right? The painkillers.
Yeah,
they're so,
your body. They're
taking so much damage to the body.
Yeah, and it's just damage. It's not, like, shit that you can, like, I have to like, rest or whatever. It's like, nigga, you're getting ligament damage and shit like that. That's never, like, recoverable. Like, you're fucked.
No, yeah, and especially just, like, the culture, you know. It's, like, kind of like rock and roll shit, you know. People on the road, they want to drink, yeah, you know, do drugs, live that party lifestyle and shit.
So they need to be hopped up.
But
on
take
opioids.
That and then add CTE to it, you know. Taking drops on your shit. Fucking head every single week and shit.
Damn, that is crazy. I forget about that shit. I know, like, in the NFL, they talk about that shit a lot, like CTE on a lot of these athletes. But WWE or just wrestling in general being one of those sports that CTE is a big issue as well.
Yeah, because it's different. Because, like, in the NFL, you got, like, multiple, like, health people looking at your body, like, making sure you eat right and shit like that.
But even then, that's not enough.
Don't even get benefits.
Yeah, they out there dolo, my nigga. Like, they get hurt, they fucked. Like, yeah, that's
not drink enough. Alcohol and rub that shit off.
Yeah, that's why they just fucking slam opioids all day.
Yeah, they probably
they get
do.
Addicted.
They probably do, man.
That's why you got to support, you know, your local wrestling and indie, bro, because these motherfuckers are pulling their bodies on the line. The
micro wrestling.
Yo, that's micro wrestling. Micro wrestling. Yeah, they were just—they were just here.
I know, bro. I seen somebody win, bro.
They were just here, bro.
That's hard, man.
Who's your favorite micro wrestler?
Oh, what's the Elgato? What was the cat nigga? Remember the cat?
He's
nigga?
The lamest one, bro.
He's always sick as fuck. Which
he's like Elgato.
Yeah, I love.
Who's
that
your
guy.
Favorite micro wrestler?
I don't know, bro. I don't watch wrestling like that. Like, I don't watch the micro wrestling shit. I don't know.
I think I like micro Jackson.
Micro Jackson.
Micro Jackson.
I don't remember because they roll up with like a different lineup.
No, it's the same cast, bro.
Yeah, but they add like new members and shit like every year.
Sometimes, but Micro Jackson, it's funny because he's not even able to wrestle or walk, bro.
Oh,
he's literally just like
he's small as hell.
He's like 1 foot. Yeah.
Oh shit.
Oh shit. Bro.
He's small as hell. Then
I like
bro.
That they getting at it, bro. I like it.
Shout out to the micro wrestlers, bro. Keep doing your thing, bro.
Now we definitely got to pull up. Like, I think that'd be like a fire
sure.
ass, like an episode
sure.
of us being in the micro wrestling shit.
Do a little like Channel 5 type shit. Where
we're like,
with it. You feel me? That'd be hard.
That should be hard.
We should just cover the wrestling scene. Like, I think that's something I'm going to take upon myself and just go to like the independent shows.
Yeah, like,
record shit, interview wrestlers and shit.
Doesn't like New York City have like Matt Underground shows and shit like
yeah,
that?
Yeah, they got House of Glory and then they got their own shit. Like, New Jersey has a GCW. They go to Atlantic City a lot, yeah.
Oh, we're
shout out to a wrestling, bro. Yo, Lasquez lied on his shit, bro.
Yeah, niggas be lying.
Lasquez showed me the fucking he told me, he's like, yo, I got moderately autistic. And then I'm like, all right, bet. He's like, hold on, I retook it. I got low symptoms. Like, nah, nigga.
Nah.
Bro, I hope we get sponsored by Chicken and Go.
I would love that.
Hey, beat it up, beat it up, beat it up. Yeah. Yeah.
Turn it up.
Yeah, yo, is Yapo JJ the hardest rapper out right now?
No, I don't think so, but I like him a lot.
Damn. Yo, why he coming like he not the hardest rapper right now?
Is he to you?
Oh, the hardest rapper this year is going to be Seppi.
Seppi? Yeah,
Seppi going to be the hardest rapper of 2024.
Oh, yo, I didn't use any of his songs last time. I'm going to use his songs for this.
Yeah, Seppi is going to be the biggest artist of 2024.
Seeing Demons, bro. That's my favorite song.
I'd be forgetting that it's like we can use those songs.
Yeah, we can. But, yeah, he's going to be number one this year.
I am. Shout out Seppi. We definitely trying to have Seppi on again, though.
Yeah, he's definitely going to be on the pod soon. But
regularly,
yeah.
Too. Man.
You just can't hop on whenever he wants.
Yeah, no cap.
So, yeah, man, we don't speak about the goals or what we got working on this year. It's just, when you see it, you see it. You catch on, you catch on. But yeah, bro. He going to be the biggest artist of 2024. Now that TikTok took away all the music from the big corporations and shit. I don't know if y'all read up on that. Universal are taking away, well, they took the music away from TikTok, like all their songs. So, like, all the big songs you see, like.
Oh,
so they, like, what are they, copywriting them?
They just took them off the platform.
Oh, shit.
And they were beefing with each other. And to be honest with you, TikTok really is the biggest app you can use to really promote your music and really, like,
get
up.
Discovered, yeah.
Yeah, sure.
That's how a lot of artists.
How do you feel about people saying that TikTok ruined music?
I don't think it ruined music. I think it just popularized good music.
Yeah.
To a big extent. You know what I mean? The thing that we suffer a lot nowadays is that we all want to be ourselves and don't be the same as every other person. But we live in a world now that everybody
has already tried everything.
Yeah, has tried everything. So even if you think you tried something, someone else already did the same thing you're doing.
It's really all about your take, though, you know?
Yeah.
And if your take is the one, the saucy one, then it's the one that blows up and shit.
But I feel like TikTok is equalizing. Like, if it hit and, like, it was a big fucking impact, but, like, now it's at its good level. Where, like, the industry is equalizing, now they're understanding.
No, I still think like
it's not like crazy.
Well, you just said that the, you know, the Universal and all these record labels are taking away the songs.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, they are. They basically are taking away the songs. I mean, they took away most of them now. It looks like they're taking away, like, you know, the popular cats that we like to listen mm-hmm. to in our age. Like, you know what I mean? Like, Cardi's music is gonna be gone. Lonely's music is gonna be gone. Ken Carson, Yee, like, those were some of the big names that I seen on the list that were gonna be gone.
That, yeah, well, so. You know, prove your point. That there's obviously, yeah, there's like Osama's son and all these new underground artists.
No, because he's also signed
to Opium.
No, what the fuck?
Who's he signed to?
I don't know, bro. But all these artists are signed. There's a reason why they do got
publishers and shit.
Yeah, it's not like they're doing this shit freely. Like, the only real artist that I know that's really mm-hmm. doing this shit freely with no label is Russ.
And
nobody here listens to Russ. I don't listen
that's
to Russ
though. That's
but like he really is the lying. Only independent artist, bro.
Russ Logic, you feel me? They independent.
Everybody.
Russ is the only independent artist. What about Puya and shit,
bro? You're talking about successful artists.
Yo, name two Russ songs right now.
I don't know any Russ songs, but I just know he's independent. I know
he's independent.
When he does his concerts, they be packed. No, really? No, like no hate shit, but like you
white
know what
people
mean?
Be like,
yeah, that's true.
I'm like, listen, like I don't listen to his music, but. Just the fact that he pointed this out a long time ago and people were making fun of him for doing mm-hmm. that shit. It's like, it really goes to show, like.
I'm not going to lie. He might be one of the hardest rappers based on the fact that, you know, he's beating up most of his ops, bro. Most of his fucking, like, people he's had grievances and beefs with. He's had his Nigerian homies pack them out and shit.
Really?
Like, yeah, they pulled up to a barbershop and beat the fuck out of Adam 22 while he was getting his nails done and shit.
For real?
Yeah, bro.
Dumb,
and then they saw he packed out Smoke Perp.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
Who else he packed out? Thousand Band Fonny, somebody. He was out here packing motherfuckers out and shit.
This nigga got, oh shit.
Hey, but
yo,
I'm saying
respect on this nigga name.
That 2018 era was like deep, bro. There's a lot going on in rap and shit. I feel like nowadays, like, you know, there's just not.
Things like they privacy.
The coverage is different and shit, you know.
I feel like privacy is a big thing right now.
Yeah. But other than that, like, it's definitely like a chance for people who want to become artists to really hop on TikTok, I guess, because since they're taking away the music away, you might as well to like,
yeah, like a little
start posting
shit.
Your shit, yeah.
Damn,
nah, for real, hey, amen. Get on them TikTok.
My copyrights, bro. Can niggas just not have a copyright shit? Like,
no, bro, that's the law.
Come on, but it don't gotta.
Why
be
would
like
you want to not deal with copyright?
I would love a free market with music. Like, I would love that.
That would be beautiful, especially like
it would be great for art all over the world. Come on,
like they should do that for. I've been coming artists. I guess some upcoming artists got to be like okay with letting shit sometimes slide. You know what I mean? Because then you never know if that gets recognized or not.
Yeah.
That's the way I see it. But yeah, I mean, definitely take your chances on TikTok if they're going to do that shit. Because I feel like even though we hate TikTok, that shit got billion people on that bitch. So
yeah, it's just eyes, bro. Potential eyes.
Just keep posting on that shit, and if you catch on, you catch on, bro. But just don't stop. Nah, but it's definitely an app that you should
mitigate. Like, definitely don't be on that.
Yeah,
bitch
or delete
all day.
That shit, bro. Cause like,
Bray yeah, Rock,
you probably will have a better life if you delete it. Definitely.
Yeah, definitely. Like that's another thing. Like, remember how life used to be without TikTok?
Like engaging and fun,
bro. Yeah, everything was more like outside and shit. Now you got people doing little target runs.
Target runs.
Yeah. Yeah, dumb shit. Oh my
Which
god.
Don't get me wrong, like, you know, Brody got a bag from doing that shit.
You
so
that fucked it up. You think shit like Vine and all these like short shit just
I don't
fucked
think that
up.
Fucked it up. I think it was more so.
Did you see the like fucking the TikToks of people like acting out social interactions and shit? It just like,
well, like what do you mean when they're ordering food?
Not even like, doing, you know, like they make memes like, you know, there's the Target runs and shit, which is like the fake day in the life type of shit, but it's like the fucking skits at this point where they're just like, when the boys recognize you for saying something funny. Like some shit where like that was like, awkward. That was awkward, but
what is like the image or something? Like,
no, like literally about? Like skits, bro, where he's playing, it's like Vine where he's mm-hmm. like, you know, playing all the parts and shit. But like,
oh, the, yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, the theme is, or like the message is like just sad because he doesn't have any friends.
So ew,
he's pretending he has friends. Like,
that's some shit I'm like, you feel me? I go right past that bitch. Go, I don't know. Like,
you could definitely tell. Like, you could definitely tell Chino depressed, bro. Because there's no way.
Make me
like,
laugh, bro.
Yeah, why you watching shit like that, bro? Like, that's corny.
That's like cringe shit, bro. Like,
yo, shout out Rich Off Skids, bro. Them niggas is hilarious, bro.
I want to give him credit. I forgot their name, though. Yo, he funny as hell. Like, he go up to people and then he'll say some funny shit, like some crazy shit right after. Like, I forgot what it was.
I think he's called
it
a show or some shit. How you call it? K-Moon recorded me doing one of their skits. Like, I just asked some random ass white kids. I'm like, yo, like, what's the last time you showered? They said 2 days. I said, you disgust me, motherfucker, bro.
Oh, yeah, I saw that. Saw that on his weak ass little Finsta. Yo, follow this man's Finsta, bro. He be doing hard work on there.
Tight shit.
Yeah, he really the only diva that got a Finsta. That's crazy.
Tight shit. I'm lit, bro. I be having fun every day, bro. Like,
hey, what else?
That's all I got
to
say.
What else is there to do but have fun? Generational trauma. Do you think you've recognized your own generation trauma?
Not really, but I know it's there. I know it's like a lingering, lurking kind of thing, you know?
I'd be, like, asking my mom and shit. Because I feel like I can really get the answers if I, like, ask the generation before me.
Exactly, through talking to them and shit. You understand, like, where they're coming from, how they were how they were raised, and, like, what kind
of
lives
I see how she acts, and I'm like, oh, shit. Like, I know what, I kind of, like, I know what not to do, you know, and I kind of know what to do based on, like, how she acts.
But it's also, like, in you, you know, like.
Yeah. I got, like, my own, you know, version of that shit. But I don't know, bro. I think I'm pretty good. I think I'm on the ways of solving it, you know?
I think I need therapy, like, fast and bad.
Yeah, you need, like, the Sopranos, like, in a dark room.
I need to see the shriek. The sheet.
Yeah, shrink.
The shrink.
Yeah, yeah.
The shrink, motherfucker.
Like, a dark room.
Why don't you go get therapy, then?
Because I don't got money or insurance. Yeah,
bro,
know.
Bro. I tried to do it, bro. They told me to go fucking, you know, tee up, nigga. That's how they told me.
Tee up.
They were like, tee up, nigga. You good.
Yeah, push like, your big boy pants on.
What?
That's how they be like.
I'm going to give you a number, bro.
They be like, you a man. You don't need therapy.
Literally, bro. They were like, I'm gonna get in contact.
Go to work, pussy.
I'm going to give you a call. Never give me a call.
That shit got to be ass, bro.
Therapy?
No, just in general. People that don't care.
Yeah, even a doctor.
The world doesn't care, bro. That's why, like, you ask me, like, ain't shit to smile about. Why?
It's so fucked up. This world, like, the way I've been looking at it lately has just been crazy. You got, like, everybody facing some type of mental issue, and, like, no one's really talking about it. No one's really, like, saying how they're really feeling and shit. And you just got so many problems going on, bro, in this world.
Yeah, that's why school shooters are, like, or just mass shooters are a thing, you know? Because they go undetected by society, you know?
Yeah.
They're just, like, pushed away, and it's, like, you know, also, they don't really have anybody to reach out to, so they just manifest in these manifestos.
Red-pilled ass niggas, you know, they getting caught in a fucking
TikTok, bro. It all leads in together, you know?
It's all of them gets caught in, like,
the shit they consume, bro. Consumes them.
Videos. Then they're, like, some weird incel, and then they, you know, shoot up a school, and it's crazy.
Yeah, that is crazy to me. Shooting up a school is insane.
But, yeah, don't you think that, like, we're just now realizing the mental illness? Like, we're just not, like, we already had it. Like, it's not, like, new.
No,
but like we're not realizing that, like, damn, we're fucked up, you know, like we got some issues.
Yeah, I mean, we all realize that shit at one point. It's just too much shit going on, but you also realize like everybody got some type of issue going on.
I think people are gonna get diagnosed. A lot of people need to get like diagnosed for illnesses.
Even if you get diagnosed, you still can get misdiagnosed.
That's true. Yeah, that's true. But you need to go to a psychiatrist.
But there's also a lot of people self-diagnosing.
Yeah, don't do that shit. If you're self-diagnosing, don't fucking do it. Go to a psychiatrist and get diagnosed.
Yo, what are we gonna do now with the students that we have now, like that be using like these websites to cheat?
The cheating.
Good for them, bro.
No, I'm saying though, like imagine like some of these people are gonna be doctors.
They're gonna build AI to detect, you know, AI usage.
But it's all like doctors is basically, it's all memorization, really.
Really, yeah.
It's all basically like all the practice you could get in real time. You can't cheat on that shit.
What if you forget something? What do you do? You go back to the book, you Google it.
Yeah, you go back to the book. And a lot of it you don't really need, because only like surgeons and stuff and like people in operating rooms really have to like know everything. So they break down like, oh, we have this problem, so I got to do this now and shit like that.
You think doctors be Googling shit?
For hell sure. Fucking yes, nigga. Like they a lot of your
WebMD like a motherfucker, bro.
Yeah, your primary doctors could be like.
They be in the WebMD chest.
So your chest hurts? They be like, yo, you got lung cancer, my G. Yeah.
Sometimes it's cool, sometimes it's bad, bro. Sometimes they give you horse medicine. Sometimes they just want to like prescribe you.
Fuck, bro. I don't even want to think about that because there really is some really bad doctors out there.
Yeah.
And they're only out there for their pockets.
Bro, it's like, just in this podcast alone, I realized like everything's connected. You know, that's pharmaceutical companies. How are they making money? By getting people hooked on
drugs.
You
know what's crazy? Like I have people who are in a pharmaceutical company though.
Painkillers.
Yeah. But I'm saying though,
they don't actually solve your pain. They just give you pain relievers.
They create drug epidemics, you know, where people are addicted to this shit. You know,
I hope y'all beat that.
Tranquilizer. Well, go ahead.
My bad. Julio. Go ahead, bro.
I keep going.
This season, I want to say something. This season, we not doing shit like that. So if you really do want to say something, just speak up, bro. And I'm going to shut up. Oh. You feel me? If there's a situation where niggas talking over each other, just you feel me? I'm going to yell at Chino. Chino going to yell at you, whatever the fuck.
This nigga think he the teacher.
I am, because you two fucking gibbies over there just talk over each other all goddamn day.
That's like I was saying, though, right? So, at my job, I had somebody that was in the pharmaceutical industry. And I was just asking him questions about, like, how does that work and shit. Because I know y'all, like, I don't watch TV like that, but when I do watch TV, you get those pharmaceutical ads, right? And it's always of them being happy, this and that. Yeah. But if you guys ever really pay attention to what they're saying, they'd be like, side effects. Cause cancer,
yeah.
Side effects, blah blah blah. But it'll be like some happy, like, and then they'll show the people like happy as hell, running around, like, and people don't realize like you're taking these drugs, and that shit is dead ass killing you.
Yeah, bro.
They be putting the videos, do.
Yeah, and it's a fucking.
It'll be like side effects.
Commercial for OxyContin, nigga, and I'm like,
may cause cancer.
I'm not gonna be happy like that.
And then they'll speed that shit up so you won't hear that.
I don't like doing any of that shit because I just know when I got diagnosed for ADHD and they started giving me the pills when I was a kid.
Yeah,
they fucking like that shit killed me. Like it killed my soul, my nigga. Like I was just in the darkness in my room all day, like with no emotion.
You don't take them no more?
Nah, I stopped taking.
Looking
them,
like, at the water bubbles float, just
yeah, dead ass. Like I stopped taking it after a couple of weeks, but mom took me right off.
Have you ever been on psychedelics and then watch commercials like on TV?
It's one of the worst
feelings in the world because. You read between the lines and you see all the subliminal messaging. You see the way they use like music and like fast paced editing and like just like savory details. And then you're like, wow, this is fucking brainwashing. Yeah. It's really poisoning you. Like the shit they're selling to you is poison.
That's why marketing is like a fucking slippery slope.
It's just all a psychology thing. It's just like, that's all. If you ever take psychology class, you'll learn a couple of like these things of how like the human mind really works, bro. Like some people are really good manipulators and they're really good to the point where they know how to manipulate a person. Like you see it all the time, especially in like younger age. I feel like in relationships, you'll see a lot of manipulators, especially like in the male side. They'll be very manipulative to the females.
Also in the females though.
Oh yeah. Also in the females as well. Like, but it's just like, it goes to show that people know how to control other people and it doesn't have to be on any kind of like, oh, me holding them up. Nah, you can control somebody. You can fuck somebody up mentally and be controlling that way. Mm-hmm.
It doesn't have to be this like grand show of like crazy shit. Like it's just like small little fucking cues that like make you fucking brainwashed or some shit.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying though. Like we get so subliminalized with all this kind of shit that like people got to start to wake up and people got to start to realize that like the government's intentions on you aren't always good. Like they're always pushing you this type of weird agenda out there.
They're never really on your side.
You just gotta understand how they. Like who they're working for, bro.
At the end of the day, once you realize that all this is a whole business, and you look at things as a business perspective, then you kind of start to realize, okay, so everybody's just in here for a buck. Yeah. No one's ever doing anything for the kind of the heart.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It's, there's no longevity in, like, government offices. Like, they're not working to, like, build our country in the long term at all. They're working to, like, fill the company's fucking pockets for that, yeah, that yearly income or whatever.
Let's talk about Israel, you know. Why are they backing them up so heavy? Because they're highly invested in this war.
Yeah, that's basically
Israel
our...
Israel makes money for...
Israel is our base in the Middle East. That's, like, yeah, our base. That is our home. But, like, if Israel wasn't there, we would just make another one.
Isn't it so crazy? Like,
Biden said that, bro.
This is the part that hurts me the most. Like, our money we pay for as... The money we pay for in the government, our taxes...
It's going towards that.
Funding a genocide, bro. That shit's painful, bro.
No one really thinks about it. Yo, like, think about how fucked up our country is. We have military people homeless. Nothing.
On the streets, nigga.
We have people...
Addicted to drink.
Yeah, we have... Yeah. Look at the fent problem going on in Philly, bro. Look at how, like... They civilize, like, low-income, like, people and stuff like that. It's just insane. Well, like, you learn that, I feel like, everything's been so negative.
Since 2020.
Yeah, everything's been so negative. Like, the media's always pushing this scary agenda on people to the point. Like, it's just making you lose control. Like, you start to see a lot of people lose control nowadays. Like, I think I seen a video recently of a dude beheading his dad and then talking about all the issues that's going on in America just because he was a person that worked
for the government. That was his reasoning?
Yeah, he killed his dad because he said, quote unquote, he's a traitor for working for the government. And then he went on by saying how the government, you know, like.
That's what I'm saying. Everything ties into each other. You know, these are people that are like, you know, the media they consume has like ruined their lives and they're not getting checked on routinely by any psychiatrist, by any other adults that like recognize the symptoms of like a murderer in the making, you know. And I feel like porn has to do a lot with this shit. You know?
Oh, yeah. We get pushed that shit so heavy nowadays. Like, no weird shit or anything at all, but I did a test before. Like, I looked at everybody, especially guys on their news thing, like, on their feed. Everything most of the guys have is literally just
booty cheeks.
Yeah, like, females over. Like, and this shit is crazy to me. Like, you really get pushed this weird agenda. Like, that's all you want to look at. Like, that's all they want you to make you look at. You see that shit on Twitter. You see that shit on TikTok. You see that shit on Instagram.
And it's like how easy that access is for children. You know, it gives them like the, you know, that pathway to like dive into deeper slopes, darker slopes and shit, you know.
Yeah,
become
like that's,
incels, you know, become like perverted, like, you know. All that shit has to do with porn. And at the other side of that shit is like the other type of media you consume, you know, is like red pill, you know, guns and everything. Like, it's kind of like pushing you to like go and act on it, you know, like. Want to start shooting shit up for the things you believe.
Because when I want to look at, like, what's mainstream, I go on, like, Snapchat and I look at the stories that they're making or some shit. And I'm like, oh, okay, this is the mainstream.
It's
right
garbage
now.
Anyways.
And I'm like, it's the most, like, insane niggas. And I'm like, I look at these niggas in a daily. I see, like, their clips. And I'm like.
But you know what the problem with
this
that
is? This is what kids are watching. Like, this is the content that they're absorbing, bro. Like, that's insane,
but
bro.
You know what the problem with that is? It's getting pushed on people, millions of people over and over.
Yeah, over and over again.
You'll see these social media pages repost this shit over and
thousands
over.
Thousands of clip channels just making the
everything
same
would just,
shit.
Everything will literally just be straight toxic going straight to people. Just toxicity. Yeah.
And I got an example of toxicity that's being like promoted to the youth, you know, with these IRL streamers, you know. We got fucking Neons, Jack Dorothy's hiding behind bodyguards and just saying outlandish shit, disrespectful shit to the working class, blue collar people. Just because, like, I don't know, it's like putting a spotlight on classification and, like, just talking shit, you know?
It just sucks of what, like, content has turned into, bruh. Because content has turned into shit like that. Like, content is, like, horny baiting and, like negative hate baiting. Like, that's basically content nowadays. Where niggas are just farming for hate or they're farming for fucking horniness.
But that's just what people want to see now.
Exactly. People want to rather watch shit they hate rather than shit they like.
Yeah,
we could we could literally have a whole hour podcast teaching y'all how to make money and half of y'all wouldn't even watch that shit. But I bet you if I have females right here with us, like with everything, y'all would sit here and watch that shit.
I watch that shit too.
Exactly. But I'm saying though, like
better pod to me.
You know what I mean? This is shit that people just want to see. I have no idea why. Like everybody needs to understand as a guy, like for us, we gotta worry about that bag. That bag gotta come first.
Cheddar.
Never like don't ever put anything between that. The bag comes first. You come first.
Family first.
All that shit comes first, bro. Like y'all get so intact.
Family first,
shit.
Bro. Do you think IRL streaming is just like dead? Like it's over? Like there's no way to revive it? Or is like, can we actually?
I mean, no, it's at its biggest, right? We got people like Kai
Sinai. It is at its biggest, but it's not like.
It's not progressing as an art form.
Yeah, as an art form, it's not progressing. It's like, as actual like good videos, it's not getting better. Like it's actually just getting worse every year. So like, yeah, I kind of want to get in there before the shit dies, bro. Before that shit explodes.
No, we don't have to get in there before it dies. We just got to bring our own, you know, our own aura, our own style to it. You know, it doesn't matter. Like just like Julio was saying, like you got to bring your own swag to shit. It'll still be IRL streaming. It's just not gonna be, you know, horn baiting and fucking hate baiting. She's gonna be like creating. That's really what I want to push.
That's what niggas gotta understand, that they like they're making money off you shitting on them on these clips. Like they purposely make themselves look bad and lame and stupid, so you can get more viewership, and then they get money off that. Like no, they're literally profiting off your hate for them.
That's why. That's what I want to promote with Lawless Youth, is just straight creativity. You know, creation. You know, I want to platform artists to be able to like express themselves, whatever they feel in the art they make. You know, whether that be drawing, making clothes, making beats, rapping, DJing, like all of the above, you know, sculpting, bro, graphic designers, like everybody. I want to get that perspective, and I want to promote creation, especially for the youth, you know. That's what they need in their lives, you know. They need some fucking like big brother figures that's going to tell them like, hey, make some shit instead of destroying some shit.
Greg Abbott trying to like entice a fucking civil war with niggas.
Can you enlighten me a little bit about this subject?
So like his whole thing is that they want to put razor wires across the border, mm-hmm. like along the rivers and all that shit. So like fucking people drown and die while they're like trying to cross the border or whatever. Yeah,
while handling their fucking, you know, 2-year-old.
Yeah, their 2-year-old baby and then like 5 kids behind them. Mm-hmm. They like drown in the water with the razor wire. And the Supreme Court put like a thing that you have to take them shits off. Like you cannot have them shits up. And this nigga Biden is doing nothing the whole fucking time.
What, has he done anything ever? He's a fucking corpse.
No, he's not. He's literally not. Like, he should definitely just send the fucking National Guard over there and wipe all that shit up. You feel me? Clean all them bitches up. But that nigga just sitting on his thumb doing nothing while niggas are dying on the border.
It's fucked up to see, you know? Because, you know, everything's broken, you know, but their system is a system that works, you know? They don't.
Doesn't work.
I mean, they hold fucking children in cages and shit.
It, like, actively fucks with whatever they're going on. Like, we benefit so much from immigration that, like, if we stopped immigration, we would be fucked, my nigga. Like, all the niggas that work in restaurants and they pick your freaking strawberries, like, all your fruit and vegetables. Like, we would be actively messed up if immigration ever stopped.
That's what I'm saying, yeah. I'm saying, like, it's a system that works, you know, like, with the way I've been watching. You know how I told y'all, like, the Channel 5, you know, series? It's kind of, like, not smarting me up, but it's making me more aware of how it works, you know? You go through this process, this traveling for months, and then you get to the United States.
Yeah.
Now you go through a process where they just say, all right, man, you're here already. You got a valid enough reason. Like, I'm going to leave you off in the side of the road and get to work. Mm-hmm. It's pretty much what they do with the immigrants, illegal immigrants.
They just ship you off to, like, Chicago.
Basically not even illegal, you know?
New York or, like, any other sanctioned city.
It's hardly illegal.
It is illegal.
It's kind of like its own process. It's up to them to go, you know, take 2 years to get, you know, legalization. But from there, you know, that's the rocky road right there. Yeah,
but they have to wait fucking 2 years, and they're just, like, on the streets, dropped off with a phone and, like, a gift card.
And a job. I mean, they don't get a job.
Yeah, they have to get a job themselves after.
But these people are determined, you know, they came from wherever they came from. Of course. So they're going to find jobs and shit.
Yeah, yeah. Like, they're resilient. Like, people from Guatemala, Senegal, Haiti, all these, Mexico, all these countries, they're very resilient people that really just want to come into the country and actually just fucking work. They just want to work. They come in here only to work. Like, that's what they want to do.
Yeah.
And we have this weird, like, idea that they're in here to do, like, bad shit and stuff like that.
That's where the Texas people are at, right?
Yeah.
They want to kind of stop that.
Kind of want to feel in control.
It's all racism, you know?
Yeah, they're not.
It's because white people have a fear of becoming a minority in this world. They've been the majority our whole entire history.
Yeah.
Our whole entire history, they've been the majority. Now they feel, like, threatened, so they're going to take, like, you know, stands, and, like, they're going to start killing people and shit.
Yeah.
What you think about that?
Why niggas? I don't know. I just feel like a responsibility to actively speak against it, because that's where, like, I come from. Like, my family had to go through the border, you know? Like, from both sides of my family had to go through the border. So, like, I just feel like I have a responsibility to speak on it, at least.
So, you know, and it's our job as first generation Americans to really fucking, you know, stamp our feet, root our feet in the ground and make the best of our opportunities and shit, just so we could put on for our next generation. And that ties into, you know, the what we're talking about earlier and shit.
Okay.
It's really like our generational trauma stems from becoming first generation Americans and having the pressure on us to really.
Yeah, we got to win.
Make a bloodline strong, you know, make a fucking family like happen, mm-hmm. you know? And if we're it. If we don't do it, shit, it's fucked. It's over with.
We're fucked. But literally, yeah, if we don't win, then it's over, bro.
That's the biggest thing about our generational trauma is the pressure we have.
The pressure to succeed. If we don't succeed, we're fucked. Our family's fucked. The family back home is fucked. The family.
But it took our parents to, you know, take those steps uh-huh. and do what they had to do to be able to birth us in this fucking
yeah, but country. I think about that. I'm like, at the end of the day, my mom did the hardest thing ever by coming here anyway. Yeah. Like that trip where you have to ping pong around countries was already the hardest thing ever. So I'm like, she had it way worse than I ever had. So like, I gotta just think about that when I'm moving.
Yeah, man.
See you, my pops.
But we can still talk about a little bit about that fashion. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I'm down. I want to talk about Pharrell because you said you didn't like Pharrell.
Who didn't like Pharrell?
I
didn't say I didn't like him. I'm just saying, like, out of everybody, you got to run Louis Vuitton.
What is this, like, you don't like Pharrell or something?
No, I never said that.
Black.
I know. Then what do you mean? Like, out of who? Like, what?
Because he's racist.
I'm just saying his style. Fuck no. I'm just saying, like, Pharrell's style, yes, he's known for his style. He's known for, like, how he's impacted just, like, fashion, culture and shit. I don't know if he's really finessing all the time with Louis Vuitton.
I think he finessed for what he did. I think his concept was a little, like, weak.
I think, like, nobody can really, like, hold Virgil's standard, you know?
Oh,
Virgil,
of course.
Virgil is different that's when it comes different. To, like...
He was, like, an innovator. Like,
that's the problem, though. Like, y'all keep comparing different designers with each other. Like, it should not be like that.
It's a different time.
Everybody has a different type of style. Like, you shouldn't compare both styles to what they got going on.
You can't replicate Virgil either. Like, he was his own, like...
You can't replicate whatever any other person does with what they want to choose to do.
That was his own shit. You feel me? But I think his concept was a little weak, just like the cowboy aesthetic and shit like that. I thought it was kind of like, you could have picked something way cooler.
I just feel like nowadays for Louis Vuitton, if it's not made from Virgil, like, y'all just think it's weak.
No, I don't think that at all.
Speak on that.
I don't get it. I think Pharrell's doing a good job so far. I think he's just trying different things and y'all just not woke enough.
That shit was hard. A lot of his jackets were fire.
Just give
I
it.
I think it's just very like Billionaire Boy Club and fucking Babe when Louis Vuitton really isn't like that.
What? No, it's... Yo, he did not see the new.
You ain't see it, bro.
He didn't see the new.
I really haven't, bro. Clue me in, bro.
It was hard. It was like a cowboy aesthetic where it was like a lot of leather.
Because he just literally said, "Babe," and some other.
Do you got any pictures of it?
I got you right now.
I'd like to see, bro. I really don't know. All right, so this is a Louis Vuitton shirt. I'm gonna get my first reaction to this shit.
All right,
I think this black jacket is cold right here. It gives cowboy rhinestone vibes right here.
It's kind of normal. The one in the middle is better though.
Is that Pusha T?
Maybe.
I don't think I fuck with this jacket like at all, bro.
Which one?
This tan and gold, tan and orange one right here.
But now you want to hate, you feel me? Like, he's not looking at it with charity. He just wants to hate. He's looking at shit to hate.
Yeah, this ain't it.
Hey, see, let's do it.
This shit ain't it, bro.
This is really not
bad. This is
bad.
Louis Vuitton we're talking about, bro. Bro could come way better, way sicker.
You act like Louis Vuitton, like the crazy, like, come on, bro, calm down.
What the fuck is this sandwich bag, bro? I'm not rocking with it.
You know fucking drip, nigga. That's why.
Okay. I'll tell you something that I do fuck with. The Louis Vuitton Timberlands.
Well, all that is just the Louis Vuitton logo on it.
Yeah, but Timberlands are a classic. You can't really fuck them up.
Yo, what the fuck?
You see that? You see how weird that shit is? Just because they got the Louis Vuitton logo, that shit's hard.
Yeah. Literally, that's the only thing that's different on it. There's a Louis Vuitton on, like, the tongue, the back of the tongue.
You could tell who really.
Fuck up. You're insane.
You're a hype beast, bro. That's one.
Yeah, you could tell
I'm
who really.
I'm really not, though, bro.
Really not.
Nobody got it. Nobody really put that shit on, like.
Tell me you're not saucing up that jacket right there.
Fuck no.
You got no fucking drip, nigga. Oh my
god. That shit is trash, bro. I ain't gonna lie, bro.
Don't know how to sauce anything up.
I gonna lie, like, y'all really disappointed me, bro. With this Louis Vuitton Goes West shit. I'm not a fan of it at all.
I say it was fire, but it's definitely not like ass, like you're saying.
Kanye West, if he was the head of Louis Vuitton, he would have came with some better shit.
That nigga's wearing socks on his fucking head, bro.
Did you see that shirt, the last shirt he designed?
Yeah.
The Get Wet t-shirt?
Yeah.
That shit hot, bro.
Nigga, I could have made that in fucking goddamn Photoshop.
But you didn't. But you didn't, though.
It's a tank top that says Get Wet.
Yes.
Are you sucking off a tank top? It's not like nothing different about it. Bro, it's a normal tank top with a
concept
fucking,
of that shirt is
that's dick suck.
You put it on that's and then dick titties suck. Get on, wet bro. In it. Like you fucking
and you horny seen, too. That's
you ever dick seen like a water contest? Like a wet t-shirt contest? Oh, that's the whole concept of the shirt. It's a wet t-shirt contest.
All right, my boys. And that concludes this episode of Roach Talks.
Episode 2,
the big return, you know, season 2.
Gonna be the big drop.
We dived in deep about like a lot of topics. Yeah. Honestly, it was a very serious episode today. You know, we just wanted to get what was off our chest about the world and shit.
Yeah, I just want y'all to think, you know, get y'all brains thinking about these subjects because they're very important to our lives right now. Feel me? So make sure to like, subscribe. You feel me? In that comment section, you got something to say, go ahead, man. You don't agree with us, go ahead. Tell us. Let us know.
If you got to this point in the podcast, I want you to comment, Gio is a hoe. Gio is a hoe.
Yo, shout out to him, bro. Shout out to Gio.
Shout out to my boy Gio. He was actually helped pick out the sample for the Last Kez beat on our last intro.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I'm rocking that.
And shout out to Last Kez too for providing the sounds for our last intro. That shit is hard.
This one I hope.
This one I hope. You know, I want to start including different sounds from different prods and shit. And shout out to Last Kez for, you know, for all the hard work and shit. Bro, it's tough.
Fire beat. Check him out on IG, bro. He be cooking.
And check out Seppi on SoundCloud, on IG, on everything.
Check me out too. Follow me, please.
Follow everybody on here.